Well, welcome all you live viewers out there. This is Katrina Holmer talking and speaking from the Kristianstad Arena in Sweden, in Kristianstad. Most welcome all of you. This is the first time that we actually organize an Agility World Championship in Sweden, and we are very excited about what we are going to live and breathe for the next 4 days here. To my left, I have Fanny Gott, my co-commentator. Fanny, what do you think about this, what we have in front of us, the coursework?
Yes, I'm very excited about this course. Let's take a look at the course map and see what we've got in front of us. So this is a course by Swedish judge Andreas Silverberg. He's a great judge, and I think he's set a challenging team jumping course for the large dogs. There are some difficult jumping sequences where the dogs really have to be good jumpers to not drop any bars. There's also a challenging weave entry where the handler has to switch sides, and then they have to leave the weaves in order to get the dog to the correct side of seven. If we look at number 11 and 12, the dog will come very sharply out of the tunnel if you want to get the right wing of 12, which it looks like most people try to get the good line 13, 14. So that will be a challenge as well, to get the dog to turn tight out of the tunnel and get that jump number 12 without dropping the bar. Really excited to see this.
Yes, he's very famous in Sweden at least, and he has been out there traveling a lot, participating in other countries, judging in other countries, and he is known for his complicated courses.
Yes, I love to run them.
Me too.
I'm always excited if Andreas is judging, because I love to run his courses, mm-hmm. but this would be a challenge for me, I think.
No doubt.
So we're getting ready.
Two minutes
left of the course walk.
There you go. This is the third course walk?
Fourth.
The fourth?
Yes,
the fourth. The last one.
Yes, we have 35 teams, and most teams run four dogs, where you count the three best dogs from that team. So you need three clean runs if you want to get to the top, I'm sure. And then the fourth dog can either make a mistake and that won't count, or if all four dogs are clean, then the best times are what's counted.
Mm-hmm.
Andreas is checking his watch. He's getting ready.
We are really going to look forward to this top-notch, world-class agility handling that is going to take place on this venue for the next 4 days. Really funny.
Yes. The handlers are getting their last touches on the course before the coursework is over. And as soon as the coursework is over, the first dog will be on the line. Andreas is getting a drink. He's getting ready. The first team up after the course walk is last year's world champions, Poland.
Mm-hmm.
And there we go! The last course walk is over.
Okay, the course walk is over.
So we are going to get ready here to start the first class of this championship.
It's taking advantage of the last seconds, the very last thing. Oh, that was the wrong direction. Yes.
And this course is 174 meters.
And there we have almost a clean course here.
Yes, and Team Poland are getting ready.
You
Andreas is checking the course, making sure everything is ready. Ready to go.
And the first of that team is Alexander Grubin with Deal.
Our first competitor today is Alexander Gronek with Deal from Poland.
This is a team with all border collies. That's, yeah, all border collies, and actually border collie is the most representative breed in the size of dogs and mostly in agility, I would say, according to the statistics that the organization have pulled out for us. We will see around there are 179 border collies entering the game this year. 179 border collies.
Yes, we're going to see a lot of border collies this week.
Are we okay to go? Is the whole team here?
Polish team is getting ready, sprinting backstage. Not sure what they're waiting on. We're missing a Polish team member.
Who are we going to see next? After Poland, we have Sweden, actually, the host
yes.
country. We are having Denmark as a third team and Colombia as the fourth team.
Yes.
Now they're ready. Are you ready, Bunny?
I'm very ready.
Very ready.
Yes.
So let's let the game begin.
Here's Alexandra with Deal. And you'll see in front of the first jump, there's a helper making sure that no one starts before the judge gives his signal. And we are ready.
It will be interesting to see how...
Into the weaves, nicely.
There you go, yes.
And she has to leave the weaves. Oh, that's very nice. So that difficult backside, no problems. Into the tunnel. Backside of 12, no problems. This looks nice.
It's interesting to see how the... It will be interesting to see how different handlers will negotiate the course. Andreas is always making...
Yes, we have
an effort to have different options. So we'll see if we will see that here.
Clean run.
Clean run.
I think the time is 33:59.
Mm-hmm.
Now, next.
Chica.
Nice weaves there. We have Chica with Monika Rilska. This is a very nice dog. I remember 2015. Oh, she missed the weave entry.
Mm.
In 2015, she won the individual agility run at the World Championships with a great run. Too bad about that weave entry. Nice to the backside of 12. Ooh, she got that. Nice. Wrap on 18. Two jumps to go.
The home stretch.
Yes.
There you go. Yeah.
But
a pity that happened.
Yes, we have a refusal for Chica, but we have two more dogs to go from Poland, and if they are clean, the team will be clean.
The next dog is Applause with Iwana Golab.
Yes, this is a young dog, only 3 years old, but very successful. Nice weave entry.
Oh, and she can leave it there. That's nice.
Oh, we have a bar. Too bad. So Poland will have a total of at least 5 faults. Nice. Very tight turning dog. Two jumps to go. Yes. So five faults for Ivona Golub and applause. Next up, Magdalena Dziewska with Mati. Yes, into the weaves very nicely, and she can leave the weaves, pick the dog up on her left. Nice. Into the tunnel, get that tight turn. Very good. Still clean. Very nice, smooth lines. Into the tunnel and just two jumps left. Can she make it with a rear cross? Yes.
And we have a clear run. Here you go. Very nice.
And now we're getting ready for Team Sweden. First up, Jenny Dam with Lily. They've had an amazing year, winning the Swedish Championship and the Nordic Championship.
Well, this team in a whole, I mean, Jenny and Lily, they have been so successful since Lily's career started.
Yes, they've been second in the World Championships.
She's a little slippery in the weaves.
Yes, but she's clean into the weaves. Very nice. Into the tunnel. She's going for that tight turn. No problem. Over the long jump. Perfect line there.
And it's fast, very tight.
Really nice. Into the tunnel and she blind crosses.
Yes.
Clean run for Jenny and Lily.
Very nice, Jenny.
Good weave entry there. She slips a bit, but she makes it. So next up for Team Sweden is Ebba Eriksson with Jazz. This is their first time at the World Championships. Nice tight turn there.
She chose another way there.
Yes. Clean into the weaves. Good independence. Very nice. Into the tunnel.
Oops.
Ooh, very tight, and he drops the bar. Yes, he was just a tad too tight there. And she blind crosses out of the tunnel, two jumps to go, and she's five faults, one drop bar, unfortunately. Next up, we have Juni Orenius with Mila.
Oh, this is really a world-class team. We have two of, I would say, the world's best handlers. One of the best handlers, or two of the best handlers in the world. Jenny Dam and Joni.
Yes, and Joni is one of few people that have been competing at the World Championships for two countries. He's won an individual bronze for Finland with his older dog. But with Nela, he represents Sweden as he lives here.
Very successful handler too.
Yes, very fast handler. And good singer.
Very nice singer. We did hear the special song that he has composed for this special occasion. Fantastic.
Yes. And there are clean.
Very nice. Come on,
Joni. Two jumps to go.
And he blind crosses, and yes!
And we 34-47 is the time.
I'm not very sure about Nela's height, but she's not a large dog.
She's a very small dog. So last up is Jenny Dam again, this time with Siv. And this is Siv's first World Championship. Mm-hmm. She's 4 years old. And she was second in the Nordic Championships this year. So Jenny took gold and silver. Now Jenny has to run clean with Siv for Sweden to be clean in the jumping round. Very nerve-wracking. Into the weaves nicely.
Nice independence.
Yes. Looks like Jenny's taking it easy to make sure she gets that clean run.
It is actually a good dog to start the fourth one there.
Ooh, yes.
She can take it easy.
She is taking it easy, making sure that she's not dropping any bars. And it looks good. Two jumps to go. Yes.
Wow.
We have a clean run, and Team Sweden is clean in total. 34.88 is the time for Sweden. So, Team Denmark, first up, Shani Elmstedt with Mayday. This is a fast dog. She goes for the wrap. She gets a bit of a wide turn there. Into the weaves. Yes, she makes it. Nice. Oh, she rear crosses the tunnel. Pushes out on 12, nice. And she wraps that jump. It's the first dog we've seen that wraps number 16. And she runs and she rear crosses 21. We have a clean run. Time of 35.42.
So we actually have some current ranking here. You will find it live on the website. Jenny Dam is leading for the moment with Lily. And second is, well, it's a whole team, we should say. There's the five fault on the Swedish team.
Well, it's a total of, it's a clear result for the Swedish team
as we can
discount the fourth dog that had a drop bar. So on the course now, Paul Lerke with Nala. They are clean so far.
Now, Paul, he is old in the game. He has been in many world championships.
He also chooses the wrap on 16. He blind crosses
out.
Yes. Another clean run for Team Denmark. Third dog in Team Denmark is Morten Juhlhansen with Spotty.
Oh, we have quite a few Danish spectators here, too.
Yes, we're very close to Denmark, actually. Very close. So the Danes must be happy that they can just take the train here.
Hmm.
They could sleep at home if they wanted to. Very nice. Very steady. He pushes out. Nice line there. Into the tunnel and two jumps left.
Very smooth.
And another clean run for Team Denmark. This means that Denmark will have a clean result in the jumping round. They have one dog left. Ann-Britt Gravlenkrat with DJ. So their job now is to set a good time. Into the weaves nicely. Clean so far. Pushing for speed.
Nice to see such an experienced team there.
And she wraps. 16. Into the tunnel. Two jumps left. We have a fourth clean run. I don't think their times will be as good as Sweden's, but we'll have to see. They're in second place.
It's not that big of a difference.
They're about 4 seconds slower than Sweden in total.
So we have the Colombian team coming up. We really hope that they are focused. In spite of what's happening here in the lost dog, the Colombian dog that has still lost in the woods. We crossing fingers for the Colombian team. First out, we have the...
This must have been a change of order. This must be David Rodriguez.
Exactly. What I commentator said, the live speaking is saying that they have a different order.
So this must be David?
David or Gabriel. I can't see the number on the shirt. But it must be, but there are three. They're running only with three dogs on this
37,
team.
37.85.
Nice run.
Clean run for David and Kate.
So now we have Juliana is running with the dog, a border collie, Trek. Juliana Blanco de Colombia.
Yes, very nice independence in the weaves. Still clean. Nice smooth run.
Now there are only three in the team, so they need to do this clean.
Yes.
They don't have the
they don't have a fourth dog.
They don't have a fourth dog. They could count on the results.
Ooh.
So far they are doing good.
No,
that is a pity.
They dropped the last bar. That's one of the hardest things to cope with. Such a nice run, and then you drop the last bar.
So Gabriela is the last dog on this team. Gabriela Ramirez, also the Colombia, of course, and she's running with Duende.
And Duende means goblin in Spanish.
Got it.
And Gabriela says that this dog, in fact, is magical.
Let's hope for them some magic here. And
yes. It's their third time at the World Championships. The dog is 6 years old, and it looks really nice. Looked like an experienced team.
There you go, the home stretch here.
Yes. Very nice.
Go, yeah.
Very good job on three dogs. So a total of five faults for the Colombian team.
Well, leading, we still have Sweden, right?
Yes.
We have Sweden and Colombia
in fourth place.
So Sweden first, Denmark and Poland, and then Colombia in the results list. And now we have the next Spanish team. We have young Adrián Bajo Alonso.
Oh, Adrián, he drops a bar.
Ah, that's a pity. He's a very young handler, but is doing a really good job with his dog. That is Sucre, the name of the dog. You can hear her barking of joy.
Very nice team. Shame about that bar. Nice tight turns. Into the tunnel and two jumps left.
Yes. There you go.
Five faults for Adrian and Sucre. Next Spanish dog.
We have the next Spanish dog, number 1508, and that's Sara García Vega, and she is running with Brown. She's also a very young handler.
Nice weaves. To the tunnel, still clean. Tight turn out to 12.
Spain is a country that has evolved beautifully within agility. I follow them since that's the country where I started doing agility when I lived there. And they have very nice handlers
and
now.
Beautiful run. 35-65.
Third handler and 13 out, I would say, handler and dog is Pau Serrano.
And this is a Swedish dog named
It is.
Born in Sweden,
raised in Spain.
Nice tight turn on two. It's interesting to see the different handling options on two. You can both go with a wrap, like Super did, or you can take the longer but more smooth way. Oh, no.
Oh, that's a pity.
He gets the wrong side of number nine. That's the first dog we've seen today with a disqualification.
Well, I actually think Pau was showing her a little bit the wrong, giving her the wrong sign, so she interpreted it as going in instead of going out.
So, but Spain still has a chance because they only have one disqualified dog, so if the next dog doesn't get disqualified, they still get a result. They have five faults from a drop bar with the first dog.
Fourth dog is, her name is Tree. And Jonathan Guillem, He is a very experienced handler. I think he's been at... I talked to him before, and I think he said that he has been at 12 or 13 world championships.
Wow. And last year I remember them because they had some great agility runs at the world championships. I think they were third in individual agility and second in the team individual agility. So let's see what he can do with the jumping course today. He chooses the long way on two. Nicely. This is a very fast dog. Into the weaves. Good independence. Very nice. If they are clean, I think we can look forward to a really good time. Oh no! He drops the long jump.
Well, that is a good you see here with Gali Khan, which we could spend a few seconds on talking about. Gali Khan with are sponsoring us with the their obstacle, the equipment. You saw that the long jump is not hard pieces, they are soft pieces, which is fantastic development for the security within agility.
Okay, up now we have Slovakia. First up, Anna Pospíšilová with Roka.
Ja, de blir diskade, ja. Från fel håll.
Okay, I think we're ready again. They had to fix the long jump, but we have Team Slovakia. Slicing number two into the weaves. Nice. She wraps number eight, pushes out on nine, into the tunnel. Nice tight turn to 12.
Well, you really need to get in contact with the dog when they get out the tunnel on 11, I think it is, before the 12, in order to push them around the 12.
Yes. And a rear cross on 21, and we have a clean run. Time of 35.97. Our second dog from Slovakia is Anna Popovičová with Lace. It's their first time at the World Championships. She goes for the wrap on number two. A very nice tight turn there. Front cross into the weaves. Nice. Almost crashing into the dog from 11 to 12, but she gets it.
That's nice. That was a nice solution, I think.
Yes, and a nice tight wrap. Into the tunnel, and she blind crosses. Mm-hmm. And she is clean as well. Third dog is B with Veronika Kralikova. And this is their first world championship, and Veronika is only 16 years old. B, the dog, is 3 years old. She looks very nice, into the weaves. Good independence. Oh no! Disqualified at the same place as the Spanish dog. She goes to the wrong side of number nine. Very nice dog and handler team this. OK. Okay, so now it's up to Pavel Vakonic and Fiona. They are the fourth dog in the Slovakian team, and they are very experienced. They were first individual in the World Championships 2015. And this is Pavel's ninth time at the World Championships, so if someone is going to save the Slovakian team, it's him. Wow. He wraps number 8 and pushes out on 9. Nice turn out of the tunnel. And yes, he gets it, still clean. Into the tunnel and a blind cross. He barely made it, but they are clean with a time of 34.06. Sweden is still in the lead. Coming up, we have Switzerland. Slovakia made it into second place, about 3 seconds slower than Sweden. From Switzerland, number 1, Janine Dlor with U2.
So ranking list so far is Sweden in the first place, Slovakia in second, and Denmark third place preliminary.
Yes, and these are the three teams that are clean. Long way there, but they are clean.
Yep. Clean run.
36-13. Next up, we have Sylvan Zumthorn with Penny.
This is Sylvan Zumthorn with Penny.
Nice wrap on number 2. Front cross into the weaves. Very nice. This is an experienced handler. Ooh! That dog didn't read the turn out of the tunnel and took number 12 from the wrong side. Too bad, it was a nice run.
Yeah, the miscommunication there a little bit when the dog came out of the tunnel, didn't breathe him. And they accidentally bumped into each other.
Number 3 from Switzerland is André Mühlebach with Lynn. Nicely into the weaves.
That's fast.
Looks like a very fast dog.
Mm.
Let's see how
contact. There we go.
Yes.
It's very important that you get into contact with the dog. That the dog sees you.
Out of the tunnel, yes.
Uh-huh.
Nice. This is a very nice smooth run. And blind crossing out of the tunnel. Wow. 34-33. Still a second slower than Jenny Dam and Lily. We have the fourth dog from Team Switzerland. This is Christian Freyend with Braveheart.
They're going to put the tunnel in place. Security above all.
Yes. So we have a short break to correct the tunnel.
So at the last dog right now, right, for his Switzerland team?
Yes, this is the last dog in the Team Switzerland, and they have one elimination, so they need to get around this course without an elimination. So he should be trying to be steady and clean. Oh, he drops a bar. Oh, and he refuses the tire.
you can really see the break of focus and concentration when they drop the bar.
Yes. But he's
and
not,
that's why he missed the...
Yes, so we have one dropped bar, one refusal, but he's not eliminated, so Team Switzerland is still left in the competition.
Uh-huh.
He rear crosses number 21. And 10 faults, 38-83. Next up is Team Portugal.
Portugal, yes. Julio Rodriguez is first out with the Belota.
Quite a big turn there from 2 to 3. Front crossing into the weaves. He stays with the dog. He has to run to push her out, but he gets it. Oh, and gets
him. Seems a little bit out of phase here, but he's struggling to get back.
Still clean.
There you go. Probably a little bit nervous. I would be.
Me too. So, still clean into the last tunnel. Two jumps to go.
And there you go.
Yes, we have a clean run.
Nice, very nice.
At 39-14.
So, the second player in this team, or second handler, I'd say, is Sergio Sousa from Portugal. And he's running with his dog, Cat.
And I think I've seen Sergio at every world championship I've been to. This is a very experienced handler.
The Sousa family, I think they have been participating long time here. Since a long time ago. There you go. They start, wrap around.
Very nice tight wrap. Front crossing into, no. Stays and he rear crosses the weaves. That's nice. Oh, he almost ran into the jump. And get the correct side. Yes, still clean. Into the tunnel. Get that turn. Very nice turn. Oh, no.
That was a pity. The dog didn't breathe his hand and she just...
She ran past the jump into the tunnel, and that's an elimination. Too bad. It was a nice run.
That leaves the rest of the team to a need for clean runs.
Yes.
A little bit of pressure here, and we have Isabel Guedes with Kira.
Nice
entry.
Oh, get! Oh, nice. She can really handle her dog from a distance.
There you
but
go.
We have some miscommunication here, but she's still clean. Into the tunnel. Oh, very nice independent backsides. This looks like a very well-connected team. Mm-hmm. Even though the handler isn't that fast, the dog is very responsive. And we have a clean run.
Nice.
37-97. So two clean runs,
and they have the elimination, so that leaves Luis Sousa in the pressure of a clean run. But Luis is also a very experienced handler, so he will probably make something good out of this.
Nice tight turn there on number two. Into the weaves. He pushes out of the weaves and he has to run to get that backside.
Oh, they are very
ooh, yes. Some awkward jumping there, but the dog saved the bar. Into the tunnel. And a backside. Good.
A very responsive dog.
Yes. Still clean.
He reads his handler beautifully. Now let's see if Luis
jumps to go.
Wow, nice clean run. Nice
run. So we have three clean runs for Team Portugal, which puts them into one of the four first places here. We have four clean teams.
And this is 1-6-3.
Up now, we have Team China. And They are quite new at the World Championships. I talked to them before, and they've been here since 2011. Mm-hmm. They have a very long flight to get there here, at least 12 hours, they said.
And nice to see new countries in the game.
Yes. This dog's name is Sasha. Nice. So far. Oh. Yes, into the tunnel. Push to 12. Still queen. Into the tunnel, two jumps to go. And we have a clean run.
Nice. It's beautiful to see when they finish a course and see the how important it is to really take your dog first and tell the dog how good they have done the work and give them a toy or a treat.
Yes, now we have Yao Qiang with Burton. Nice. Into the tunnel. Let's get that turn. Nice turn. It's great to see the development of the countries
yes.
that start out in the World Championships and then getting better and better every year. We have two clean runs from Team China. The third dog is named Robin with Zheng Tang.
Someone's in a hurry to start.
Yes. Cross into the weaves. Yes, he got it.
Nice
independence.
So China has two here.
Looks like the dog is making an effort not to hit any bars.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, and then he dropped
that. That is a tricky one, number 12.
Very hard. Oops. Where are you going? Good. Into that last tunnel, run. He rear crosses 21. And we have five faults for Robin. So we have two clean runs and one dropped bar. So this puts pressure on our fourth dog, Hizhu Song with Jinni Winu. Another red border collie.
Oh, beautiful.
Very nice. Can he give China a third clean run? That would be amazing for them. Dog touches the jump wing, but the bar stays up. And he takes...
Ooh.
Ooh. No, no, come on. Oh. Good save. And just one jump to go, and they are clean with the
That was really interesting. You can see
yes.
Andreas how he starts
yeah.
on alert to see if he should judge something here that
so
he wouldn't like to.
Yes, we have three clean runs for Team China. And that puts them in fifth place. As you can see, we have five teams that are clean.
So Team Finland out here, number 10.
Janita Leinonen with Fu. They are an experienced team.
They are really an experienced team. I only see well-known names here.
Yes. Fu is 7 years old, and she's been eighth in individual world championships, and she's been second in team, so they are really experienced and really fast.
Next year, I think the agility championships will take place in Finland.
Yes. They are clean with a time of 35 seconds. We now have Tulia Liuto with Pirtu.
This dog is 8.5 years old. They have obtained silver.
This is an experienced dog at 8.5 years old. They have won a team silver for Finland. And this handler also has been second individual in the World Championships with her older dog.
Experienced handler, as you said. She doesn't mean miss a detail here.
No, it looks really nice.
Tight.
Nicely jumping dog. Very nice. Tight turn there. Into the tunnel, and she rear crosses 21. And they are clean as well, with a time of 34.59. Jenny Dam's time with Lily is still going very strong.
And we can hear the Finnish people over there. They have also sent a few people over here to come and cheer their team.
Yes. This is Nina Lina Lina with Thor. He's the youngest dog on this team at 4 years old. It's looking great.
Yeah, Nina Lina, she's a very experienced handler. Very nice. She shows every single little step that the dog has to take.
And she blind crosses there. Nice. Great run. 35.07.
Oh, we actually have a Gröndal.
Yes, is this the first dog that's not a Border Collie?
Yes.
It's a Belgian Shepherd dog.
Mm-hmm. Nice to see some diversification in the breeds, also in the large.
This dog is also experienced. He's 7 years old. Very good. Powerful dog. He touches the wing there, but the bar stays up. Very good. Into the tunnel. Very nice. Are they going for four clean runs? I think so.
Looks like that.
And very good. 36-27. So where does that put them in relation to Sweden and Slovakia? We have to wait and see. Next, we have Serbia. Alar. Oh, we have a scoreboard.
There you go. That's Sweden in the first place. Slovakia.
We don't have Finland yet. No.
We should wait.
Yes.
I think they will come pretty high up in the score.
I think so
scoreboard.
Too. I think they can challenge Sweden.
Mm-hmm.
But probably not. I think they'll be going to second. If I'm guessing. So Serbia up next. We are correcting some tunnels to make sure that all dogs have the same opportunity and safety. We are ready for Alar Kivilo with Tuffy. Nicely into the weaves. Pushes to seven.
And Finland
goes into second place, according to the speaker.
No. Yes, Finland goes into second place. And the first dog for Team Serbia unfortunately disqualifies as he takes the wrong end of the tunnel. Very nice dog, though. Hey, this puts the pressure on the rest of the Serbian team. And Alar will come back as the fourth handler, so he has a chance to save the team if the others are clean. We now have Mikaela Tomic, and she is running Gazela. The This is a very dark border collie.
Oh,
she drops a bar.
Crashes into the bar.
Yes.
Maybe she slipped.
The surface, she drops another bar. The surface is good, but it's still very different from running outdoors if the dogs are used to that. It takes some skill to master the indoors turf.
Mm.
So we have two bars down for Gazella.
And here we have the second non-border collie coming up.
Yes, we have
a Malinois.
A Malinois, a Belgian Shepherd dog with Miroslav Tomic.
Look at that dog. He's so eager to start.
Yes. And the dog's name is Condor. The Malinois, misses the entry twice, doesn't he?
No, he started.
And goes into the tunnel, which is an elimination.
The Jets Hawkeye saw him enter from the wrong side.
Yes.
In the weeds. Now that's a huge dog.
Yes, very powerful dog. The Malinois, the Belgian Shepherds are big, striding, powerful dogs.
But it's nice to see how we continue running with the dog so he can have the opportunity to finish the whole run
and
in a nice way for the
nicely.
Dog.
Nicely, yes. So we have two eliminations for Team Serbia, and that unfortunately means that they are out of the competition, but of course they get to run. So we have Ala Kivilo again with Trig. Ooh, late blind there, but he made it. Nice line on 16. This is a good run. Blind crossing, one jump to go, and he is clean with a time of 34.83. And the judge asks us to wait. Coming up, we have Team Netherlands. This is Susan Koldenhoff with Time. This is a 4-year-old dog, very fast, athletic dog, who likes to sleep on Susan's pillow.
The time, the 5-second pillow wasn't on, so the time is right. She got the right time. We're going to bring in Netherlands! This is Susan.
Oh, the dog is very eager to get started. She goes for the slice, I think.
Perfect.
Yes.
It is kind of important that you have a dog that sits put and does not start before he or she is allowed to. You need to get some space, you need to get out a little bit in order to handle, to manage number 2 and 3.
This is a very nice run so far. Very small, athletic dog, tight turning, very nice turn. But also very good acceleration. She veer crosses at 21,
she didn't
but it's
it.
A good time at 34.18. Next up for Team Netherlands is Esther Booth with Mojo. Mojo is also a dog that loves to cuddle and to swim. Goes for the slice.
This dog is 6 years old.
Oh, and a refusal on number 4.
It's in a split second that you don't communicate in the perfect way with the dog, and you're gone.
So let's see if she gets that turn. Very nice turn out of the tunnel. Unfortunate refusal there. And
nice.
She goes for the long way, and she does it so nicely.
Smart, so she can have a chance to get on the
yes.
right side of the tunnel.
36.68 with a refusal. This is a very good time.
395. This is Sir Kachal
we have the third dog coming up. This is Sarv Gorchalk with June. This is his first time at the World Championships with this four-year-old dog. Nicely into the weaves and good independence. Nicely into the tunnel. He's ready to push the dog out on 12.
Nice handling.
Very nice.
Perfect timing.
This looks very smooth.
Let's see if they're going to do it here on board the Netherlands.
Into the tunnel, and we have a clean run. We have two clean runs for Team Netherlands when the last handler goes to the line. This is Henk Timmer with Feng. The dog is 7 years old, and this is his second time at the World Championships. Nice tight turn there on the slice. Front crossing into the weaves. He gets it. I'm impressed with the quality of the weaving here. I think we've had one mistake in the weaves
very
so
nice.
Far.
And it's not an easy entry, because if you have a dog that's really in two tunnels, you have the tunnel there. But there is...
Yes. Oh, no. We have the wrong side of a jump, and that's an elimination.
That's a pity.
That's too bad. The wrong side of 19 as well. We're 18. That's unfortunate for Team Netherlands.
Czech Republic coming up.
Yes, we have the Czech Republic, and this is a sharp team. First up, we have an 8-year-old dog that's been to many World Championships. This is Radovan Liška with Ori. Just as we were talking about how
we shouldn't have said anything.
We have a refusal at the weaves and a dropped bar. Unfortunate. I think he was just placed wrong for the weave entry.
Yeah. It is that split second of a, you know,
and another
you get
dropped bar. A total of 15 faults so far. And he has to rear cross number 21, but he does that very nicely. We have a time of 37, 87, and 15 faults. Next up, we have a dog named Brooke with Barbara Skranitslova. Very nice dog, long striding and athletic. And another refusal at the weaves. I think we jinxed it.
I think, yeah, I shouldn't have said anything.
So nice. I really like this dog. Great jumper, very fast, very athletic. Too bad about that weave entry.
She needs to run.
Yes. Oh, yeah, you caught it. Yeah. And she jumps number 21 from the wrong side and is eliminated. That is very unfortunate for Team Czech Republic.
It was a really nice run, though.
The third dog in this team is named Jess, and the handler is Teresa Kanieva. Goes for the wrap. Nice tight wrap. Front crossing into the weaves. Can we get it? Yes, she gets the entry. And nice independence there. Nicely into the tunnel.
It's lovely to see how she is looking at the dog too, and she knows at every point of time where the dog is. That's very important.
Yes, a great handler, great dog. She goes for
the flip. Nice. Flip there.
And she rear crosses 21. And she's clean with a time 34.88. And now we have the reigning world champion individual agility, Teresa Kralova with Say. This is an amazing team that has won so much. The dog is only 5 years old, but has won so many championships that I...
Look at that. Look at that. Very nice.
They are amazing. And the arena goes quiet when Teresa is running Say.
Look at that.
Takes the slice.
Very nice.
Perfect.
Now she needs to run again.
She can run. This is amazing. We have a time of 33.85 and a clean run. This actually means that Jenny Dam and Lily are faster with a time of 33.41. In the top, we still have Team Sweden. Isn't that exciting?
It is for sure.
We
know. Are we trying not to be biased here at all?
Yes. We have Team Russia. This is Natalia Sternberg with Zaki. This dog is 3.5 years old, but has already been to the World Championships with a third place in jumping, but unfortunately, a dropped bar there. Very tight dog. And when the dog is very tight on the jumps, you can drop some bars, unfortunately. And she barely makes the rear cross. We have 5 faults and an amazing time, 33.04. That's the fastest time we've seen so far.
That is weird because it didn't really look that fast.
Yes.
But a beautiful run.
Beautiful run. Very, very fast. We have Ekaterina Povalischeva with Dizzy. This dog is 4.5 years old. Oh no, another dog taking that jump number 9 from the wrong side. And we have an elimination, unfortunately.
Well, you see it came too far out and to the right and had a turn that was too wide. And it positioned the dog on the wrong side of the jump.
Yes. Too bad. We have 2 more dogs to go for Team Russia. Have a rerun, replay of that elimination. Very unfortunate. So our third dog for Team Russia is Anastasia Lobanova with Joker. This dog, no.
It doesn't look like an Anastasia to me.
No. This must be Stanislav Kurochkin with Sippy. And this team was just amazing at European Open, but unfortunately they have a dropped bar there. But look at this team. The handling, the speed.
The long distance handling is fantastic.
And it's so fast.
And this really shows you that you don't have to be 25 and have long legs to participate in this
Look
game.
Look at that time, 32.98. This is one of the fastest dogs in the world.
And very nice.
Russia has some really fast dogs in this competition. Now we have the fourth dog, which then has to be Anastasia Lobanova with Joker. Unless I mixed all of them up. But it looks like a male.
It's a 4-4-4.
Good.
That's Anastasia.
Yes. She looks really young. Powerful, fast dog.
Russia is a very interesting country when it comes to agility. They have very good handlers.
Yes, and very good training. Very much like long distance handling, sense, independence, good skills. Very exciting
no
country to watch.
No problem for the blind crossing there.
Yes. Very nice. Nice clean run there. 34.95.
Canada coming up.
We now have Canada coming up with Jessica Patterson and Lux. This is a young dog. She is 3 years old. But she was amazing at the European Open, where she won the team agility run, individual. Very well trained, very fast dog. Oh, and she goes into the tunnel instead of the weaves, and that's an elimination.
Let's see if we can get that replay to see why the dog chose the tunnel instead of the weave.
Oh, so it's a very young dog, and this is the kind of mistakes that a young dog will make at its first world championship. It's a fast dog. Very nicely handled.
Very nicely, and she's very pay a lot of attention to the dog.
She definitely has a chance in the individual runs.
Well, that places us still here in the ranking. Sweden in top, we have Finland second, and we have Slovakia third.
Yes. Second for Team Canada is Susan Garrett with momentum.
Now we're talking experience here.
Yes, this is an experienced handler. I think she's been to every World Championships since Canada started sending Border Collies in 2008. Before that, Border Collies weren't recognized by the Kennel Club in Canada, so they couldn't go. Momentum drops number four, but keeps going nicely into the weaves. This is another young dog. The mother of this dog has been to World Championships. Oh, a refusal there. And the older brother has also been to World Championships with Susan as a handler. Oh, and Susan can run.
She can run.
Oh, and she goes around the last jump.
Yeah.
Too bad.
But still, look at that, look at that. She rewards the dog.
Yes.
Even though they didn't make the best run in their lifetime.
Now we have experience coming up. We have Summit is 9.5 years old. He's the father of Lux that ran first in this team, and also father of a dog in the Polish team. So a very experienced dog. Running nicely.
Oy.
Justine is also very experienced. She has run Shelties in the World Championships for more than 10 years. She also has a Sheltie in the medium team for Canada this year. Very nice run. Clean run, 34-66. And another experienced team coming up. This is Jessica Patterson again with Trix. And Trix is a younger sister to Summit. So she's the aunt of Jessica's Lux.
No, you know your Border Collies, right?
I know Border Collies, yes.
You're a breeder yourself, aren't you?
I'm a breeder, and yes, I like to know Border Collies.
You know the lines.
Yes. This is an amazing dog that has won the European Open individual. 2015. So experience, speed, and skill.
Look at that. Very nice. Very nice.
Yes.
Before the dog even see the handler, he knows what to do.
Yes.
Because she is quick enough to tell the dog with time.
Very nice. Two jumps to go. She rear crosses number 21. Yes. Very nice. 34-50. So we have two clean runs for Team Canada, one refusal, and then not sure how many faults momentum got. Was it 10 or 15? We're having some problems with the results. I'm not seeing
them. Not updated that fast.
They're not being updated. I don't know why. Next up, we have Team Japan.
This is team number 16.
And we have Hiroshige Yamasaki with Lacey. This dog is 6 years old and had six puppies last year, so coming back from puppies, but looks everything but Lacey. Into the weaves.
This dog is 6 years old. She has six.
She drops a bar there, and she misses that jump. It's difficult. That's the number 9 jump is what causes the most problems on this course.
Mm-hmm.
Very tight there.
I was looking for the Japanese audience. They're sitting just in front of us over there. Nippon.
Yes, they're always very exciting to watch. Mm. So we have the second dog, Kazuto Kishimoto with Yamame. This dog is also 6 years old. He caught it, but just barely. And he gets the number 9 jump. Still clean. Nice push to 12. And you can see how the dog is really, really working hard to not drop any bars. Nice rear cross there.
Nice. It's an interesting age spread here. You have dogs from, I think it was the youngest, like three years old. You need to be 3 years old to take part of the competition, I think.
No, I think there are some 2.5-year-old dogs. One in the Greek team, for example. Yes.
And up to 8. There were some 8 teachers over there.
Summit that just ran is 9.5 years old. So in the Canadian team. Now we have Takami Ono with Taki. This dog is 4 years old, and it's his second time at the World Championships. Goes for the slice at 2. Nicely into the weaves. Good independence. Push to 7. Gets the number 9 jump. And nice turn to 12. This dog takes up quite early for the jumps, which causes some excitement. But she is clean with a time of 34.75. And this handler that just ran is 55 years old, so it's not just the...
Not just the dogs, also the handlers.
We have young handlers, we have old handlers. Everybody can run agility. This is Masanori Kaitoda with Conan, and this is an experienced dog, 6 years old, very fast, very accomplished. He had some top placements individual at the European Open. We have Team Belgium coming up. Olivier Monats with Keen.
I just quick read through the agility regulation. Yes, it's a 2 years. The dog needs to be 24 months old in order to be able to take part of the competition. So it's a 2.5-ish.
Yes.
Are running a 2.
This is a nice run so far. And it's a nice clean run at 35.42. And we still have Team Sweden in the lead.
This is Pepe Kusumano with Molly.
We have the second dog named Molly on the line. The handler is Luis Kusumano.
Followed by Finland with 104.66. It's so, so, so close.
Down on the arena. They have the live results. We don't have it right now here where we're sitting, but Sweden is still in lead and Finland second.
Yes, I believe so. This looks nice. Clean run so far. Tight wrap at 18. And he makes the line cross. We have a clean run at 34-44. We now have Mark Van Beek with Gem. Blue Merle Border Collie.
Beautiful.
Nicely into the weaves there.
This is team 17.
So we're almost halfway through now with the 17th team. The 35 entering the competition.
Yes. We have this looks great for Team Belgium.
We have seen some really nice agility. Very nice. And we still have a few very interesting teams to see. We're looking forward to see.
That is a nice run. A clean run at 34.52. We have Team Belgium right
next to us,
yes. And they are happy.
They are sharing.
We have one dog left to go for Team Belgium. That's Sally Andrews with Orval. This is an experienced handler. Oh, she drops number four. But I think Team Belgium already have three clean runs.
So it's only time of speed and clean runs here.
Yes, but unfortunately
nice.
That drop bar.
Yeah.
Ooh, she was looking at number 19 before taking 18, and she barely made that line, but they get 5 pulls in a time of 35.85.
South Africa
coming up here.
Yes.
Coming far away.
We have Rob Hall with Milo. And this dog is 5 years old, and this is actually Rob's first agility dog.
Oh, and that's great.
And his second time at the World Championship, so he's had
a really good handler then.
Yes, he's had a quick career to the top.
Very nice handling, smooth.
Very smooth.
Communicative.
He goes for the slice.
Yeah, you know,
he's in front, he makes that line.
You need that long, long turn if you are going to be able to do the blind.
36-66 and a clean run for Milo. We have Leon van der Merwe with Savvy. Another 5-year-old dog.
And Belgium got into a third place so far.
Oh.
Belgium made third place so far.
Rob managed to make it to the third place.
No, I think
it was a whole team.
No, it must have been Team Japan.
Yeah.
Or maybe no. Team Belgium.
Team
into
Belgium.
The third place.
Yes. Yes.
Guys over on the other side here are in our way for the time. Please, photographers, thank you.
That means we still have Team Sweden in first place. This is a nice clean run. Another clean run for Team South Africa.
We're gonna bring in 5-1-5-1 Wayne Arniel.
We have Wayne Arniel with the Rage. Third dog for Team South Africa. Dog is eager to get going.
Oy.
Front crossing into the weaves, staying with the dog there. Now he has to really run to get that line, but he managed. And
the dog.
Then,
and now he's he said,
oh no. He got confused there for
a
while.
He got a little confused.
And then the dog missed the tire and went into the tunnel, which is an elimination.
It is actually, you know, the tire we have here. It has been used. We don't have it that many. We haven't seen it that many times here in Sweden, but it's sure it's a development of the safety in, within agility.
Yes, we tried it at European Open, and I really like it. My dog really likes it, so I think it's a great invention for the sport.
It is for sure. But I can imagine that there are dogs that haven't seen it that they hesitate a little bit.
So our fourth dog for Team South Africa is Tracy Lander with Spee. She's been to the World Championship 3 times. Oh, this is her 3rd time. And this dog actually has 2 littermates running in the World Championship. So good agility dogs, probably.
Some good genes there.
Yes. And the dog is South African, but born in the UK. Nice run so far, 2 jumps to go. We have another clean run for Team South Africa, which makes sure that the team is clean. That's great for Team South Africa.
So we are halfway through now, and the judge needs some water and some rest.
Yes,
so we're also going to take a rest here.
There will be a break.
A little break.
We will come back once the break is over. We are back. And we are back with Team Luxembourg. This is Raymond Rossi with EC.
Let's see what Luxembourg can do about this.
We are crossing the weaves. So far, let's see what he. Yes, nice line to 9. Rear crossing the tunnel, nice turn to 12. This is a really nice run so far. Fast dog. And he is rear crossing number 21. We have a slight hesitation there, but we have a clean run with a time of 35.92. Next up, we have a Dutch Shepherd dog. That's exciting. It's the first one we've seen today. Her name is Anna Winkel, and the dog's name is Hoodie. This looks like an experienced dog. And unfortunately, she pops out of the weaves. Has to take them again. Nice and steady into the tunnel. Very smooth. Not the fastest team here, but nice and steady. Unfortunate with that pop out of the weaves. We have Julie Selmar with Busy Bee. This is a 6-year-old Australian Kelpie. It's the first Kelpie we've seen so far, but there will be more. Very nice so far. Athletic little dog.
So the home stretch here.
2 jumps left. And we have another clean run for Team Luxembourg. So with 3 dogs, they have 5 faults. And it's up to Mike Peter with limits to run clean and keep Luxembourg in the game.
A little bit of different handling here. Very smooth. See how it enters into contact here. Yeah.
Yes. It's fast.
It is a tricky one out from the 11th, tunnel 11th to 12th.
Yes,
you really see the difference.
Chooses the slice on 18, and he runs, and he crashes into the dog, but he is clean.
And the judge didn't judge that. They crashed into each other.
No contact fault
so
for
there
that.
Wasn't
we
contact.
Have 34-94, and this means that Team Luxembourg is clean in total.
Next team out.
Sweden keeps the lead.
Next team out is Italy. And do we have an experienced handler here in Nicola Giraudi?
Very
absolutely
experienced. He's been competing with a Sheltie and with a Terrier. And now this is his Border Collie that took a bronze medal last year at the World Championships.
Look at that. Exactly how it has to be done.
Very nice. And he is one of the One Mind dog trainers.
Nice.
And if you've bought the live stream, you can get One Mind dogs one
beautiful
month for free.
Beautiful run.
Beautiful clean run. 33-22. That is a great time. We have a Valentina Bustero with Fiona. Another Border Collie. Nicely into the weaves, rear crossing the weaves. Good line cross there.
Very nice.
She is not leaving anything up to chance, which is with the dog in every turn. Really running with the dog, getting out of the way just in time. And she's choosing to slice number 18.
Long way. If she doesn't, she doesn't get in time.
She barely gets that line,
nice.
But it's a
barely
clean run.
Barely, but she did it.
37.05. So two clean runs for Team Italy.
Nice entrance in the booth. Very, very nice to see that in the replay.
Yes. We have Sara Penazzato with Alyssa. Very nice so far. Don't pull the dog too tight there. She makes it into the tunnel and almost crashing into the dog on that turn, but still clean. Line crossing and threadling, 16. Tight wrap on 18. Into the tunnel and two jumps to go.
Perfect timing.
We have a third clean run for Team Italy.
Oh, this is getting dangerous here for the Swedish team.
34-45, yes. This is putting the pressure on Team Sweden. We have one dog left for Team Italy. Alberto Bergamasco with Brie. Nice tight wrap on number two. Front crossing into the weaves. And since we have three clean runs from Team Italy, he can really push for time here. Clean so far. Nice turn out of the tunnel.
He's running. He's very fast.
Yes.
At least it looks like that.
Nice tight turns. Now run for that line. Yes, he makes the blind. And we have another clean run with a time of 34-42. And I think that Italy will challenge Sweden for the lead. Unfortunately,
we
the
don't
live
have,
results
we don't have,
are
yeah
down, and we don't know. We have Team Lithuania on the line. This is Algirdas Valčiukas with Rose. This dog is 7 years old, and his handler tells us that the dog has a great sense of humor. That's a good thing in a dog.
That's not bad.
Goes for the slice. Wide front cross into the weaves. Good independence. No problems with the number nine jump. Nice turn. Very nice so far. And easily gets that line cross. And we have a clean run. And a nice time of 33.76. We have another Belgian Shepherd dog coming up. Dog's name is Axis. And Jolanta Janusaskian. She goes for a wrap on number two. Great independence in the weaves.
It's a beautiful dog.
Very nice. And Katarina, you've run a Belgian Shepherd dog.
I did, I have. My first agility dog was a Belgian Shepherd. Unfortunately, she's not with me any longer. But we had the opportunity to travel a lot internationally, compete in the championships.
It's a beautiful dog, always
it's
been
in
my heart.
It's a beautiful dog, and this is his last championship at 8 years old. Mm.
Look at that.
Yes.
Oh, so beautiful.
And the handler seems to really love her breed and wants to show it to the world. Number three, then, we have Redas Masilius with Grom. Looking great so far. Touched that bar when the handler was late on the blind, but the bar stayed up. And nice turn out of the tunnel. This dog is 5 years old and unfortunately had some miscommunication there. Funny thing about this dog is that the name means thunder and the dog loves to run in bad weather. So when it's raining and thundering, the dog is having a great time.
He's having a blast.
Yes. Unfortunately, we got the wrong side of 16 and had an elimination. So for Team Lithuania, the last dog has the chance to keep Lithuania in the game by a clean run. This is Vytautas Guobis with Uno. This is the youngest dog in the team at 4 years old. Leans so far into the weaves. He is late on that line because he wanted to check that the dog completed the weaves, but he made it. He's a bit late all the time, but the dog is
saving the
saving him nicely.
Yeah.
And we have live results back, and
we
can tell you that Italy is in the lead.
Italy is in the lead.
With a total time of 102.09. Sweden second with a time of 102.76. So
and
very
third.
Tight. You can see the scoreboard in the top left corner.
Third place we have Japan.
Great Britain enters. And this is Greg Derrett with Addict. And Greg has been doing agility since 1990, so he's one of the veterans in the sport. He's been second individual in the World Championships with an older dog.
And he's ready.
Oh, how unfortunate. Dog goes into the weaves.
But actually he went on the right side of the tire.
Yes.
Which was a little bit different choice of of handling, I think, and
very unfortunate.
Pointed the dog into the into the weeds.
Greg is usually one great team player. He's been taken a gold in the team event at the World Championships, and they were second at the European Open in the team event. So very unfortunate there. Next dog up is Spring with Martin Reed. Looking good so far. No, that we have a drop bar. Unfortunate.
This is too bad for Great Britain. They're usually a very strong competitor in the team event. And as well as live results up, you can also see any faults on your screens, which is great. This is the third dog. We have Dan Shaw with Geek.
Geek.
I love that name.
I mean, it's a joy only to read all the names here. Some imagination all over the place.
Yes. Very nice so far. Nice blind to 16. Tight turns, 17, 18. And we have two jumps left, and he goes for the rear cross.
He was aiming.
But this is a fast time at 33, 32.
And he was aiming at a blind cross, but he didn't manage to get there in time. Very impressive handling here.
Yes, great team.
Very smooth.
So the last competitor for Team Great Britain is Natasha Wise with Pebbles. And if you've been watching the World Championships for many years, you know that Natasha's won the medium event many times with her border collie, Dizzy. But she's now in the large category with Pebbles. And unfortunately,
that was an unfortunate bar.
Dropped bar.
Very nice.
Nice turn to 16.
We have two really difficult places here on the course, and that is it. When they come out the tunnel at 11, to go to 12, you need to have a communication with the dog, and also on the 8, 9.
8, 9, and also 16 can be tricky for some teams.
Absolutely, yes.
Great course. So
he's a fantastic judge.
Up now, we have the bronze medalists from last year, Team Estonia. And first up is Maria Piroja with Dints. And Maria is running two dogs in this team. Both Malinois, Belgian Shepherds.
Mm-hmm.
She goes to push out of the weaves very nicely. Wow, she's a great handler.
And look at that dog. Oui.
She wraps number 8. I'm surprised with a big dog that you would do that. But
I
the
don't
dog
think it was on purpose, though.
Might not have been. She goes for a wrap there, too. This is a big, striding dog.
Long-striding dog,
oh,
yes.
It turns the wrong way, but we have 35.02 and a clean run.
Quite, really nice. Good time, because there were quite a few misunderstandings on the course.
Yes, but these Her Malinois are fast.
They are fast with
so
those legs, yes.
This dog is only 2.5 years old, mm-hmm. and it's their first time at the World Championships, so very excited to see how they're doing. Nice so far with the rear cross into the weaves and very independent weaves. They look much more experienced than they should be at 2.5 years old, so that's impressive. Let's hope that they can keep it together. Very nice. This looks so steady.
Look at that. That's really nice.
And she will have no problem making that blind. And we have another clean run with a good time, 33.65. Marge Mitt with Faye. Up next, we have Steffi Prakli with Etty. So two clean runs for Team Estonia. We need one more clean run, and preferably fast. Nicely into the weaves. Estonia is one of those countries that started out in the World Championships. Oh no, we have an elimination. So Estonia started out as an outsider a few years ago, but they have developed immensely and are so successful. Unfortunate disqualification here for Steffi and Etti. But we have one more dog to go for Team Estonia, and that is Marje with Susie, and they are experienced. If anyone can keep Estonia in the game, it's her.
It's another Malinois.
Yes.
Looking beautiful.
This is the older of the two Malinois, and she was third in jumping individual last year, so it's a fast and steady dog. Oh, no!
Oh,
she sensed the dog in the
she
right,
did that
wrong
she
end
forgot
of the tunnel.
The course.
That is so unfortunate. They had a good thing going.
But it's a beautiful run, though. I mean, if you can keep it together, just let the dog have fun. Have fun yourself, even though you
yes. Don't show the dog you made a mistake.
Never, never show
she
the dog.
Just
and she doesn't. You know, she lets him look at that dog. He's happy. He's running. He's saying, where to next? Where to next?
Beautiful dog. Oh, very unfortunate for Team Estonia. So that means that they are out of the game with two eliminations. We still have Italy in the lead, Sweden second, and Japan third. So next up, we have Team Austria. This is Katharina Koenig with Juno. And it's her first world championship with this six-year-old dog. Wraps number 8 and pushes to 9. Oh, the dog touches the wing, but the bar stays up. Pushing out to 12. Very nice so far. It's height on 16 and touches the bar, but it stays. Oh, and she makes the blind just barely, and she is clean. 37.97 and a clean run. And this is an Australian Shepherd. Might have looked like a Border Collie, but it's actually the first Australian Shepherd we've seen here today.
I'm browsing really quickly through the times that we are looking at here at the current ranking, and we have 33.22, I think the fastest, if I'm not wrong.
It's not the fastest time, but I think it's the fastest clean time.
It's the fastest clean time. At 14 first teams, it's the fastest time, and that is Nicola Giraudi.
Yes,
that's holding that time.
We had a Russian dog with an amazing time, unfortunately, with a bar down. On course now, we have Anke Bauer with Leah, and she's an Australian Kelpie. And Anke says that she's a working Kelpie couch potato at home. So likes to take it easy. Oh, a miscommunication there, but still clean. Another clean run for Team Austria with this five-year-old Kelpie. And we
and the Team
have
Austria
some
supporters are cheering.
Yes,
really
we
there.
Have some experienced handlers on the line. This is Sissi Graf with Jeremy. He's 7 years old and he's been in the game for a long time. Very nice tight turn. This is a big dog
oh,
that can
beautiful.
Turn very nicely.
Slips a little bit into the weaves there.
Yes. With those long legs. But they're in control. Very nice turn to 9. Nice turn out of the tunnel. Very nice and controlled on 16. This looks great. Oh, he's so tight for such a big dog. And she easily blind crosses. Out of the tunnel, and we have a clean run at 34.62.
This is getting exciting.
We have three clean runs for Team Austria when Lisa Frick steps onto the field with Jack. So Lisa is a very experienced handler, and she's probably the only one, I think, that's won the world championship 4 times with her older dog, Hoss. She was world champion in 09, 10, 2012 and 2014. This is Jack. He's 5 years old. And he was second at European Open this summer, so he's in great shape.
Look at that handling. Beautiful.
And he's the litter brother of Teresa Kralova's Sei in the Czech team, the reigning world champion. So great agility lines here as well. Dogs born in Italy. Perfect.
And
so
the long
nice.
Stride, now run.
This is amazing. Oh, she made it. And this time, 33.66 is a great time. We have four clean runs for Team Austria. We're very excited to see where that puts them. Amazing. They go into third place. So Sweden still in second, Italy still in the lead.
Japan on the fourth.
We have Team USA on the field. This is Shane Miller with another Malinois, Belgian Shepherd dog, named Luna. Luna is 7.5 years old. Very nice. Such an athletic, tiny Malinois. And this dog also competes in duck diving, where the dog has to jump far into the water, and she can jump over 7 meters.
Wow, impressive.
And that's a clean run.
Clean run, there you go.
With the time 35.84. Great start for Team USA. We have the second team for Team USA, Desiree Snellman with Crew. Crew is 5 years old and Desiree is 59. So definitely, even the older handlers can do great at the World Championship. Perfectly into the weaves, very independent.
And the handler positions herself beautifully.
Yes. And Desiree has an individual bronze medal from 2014 with her older dog Pace. So she's experienced and she's handling Crew very nicely. And she rear crosses. Slight hesitation, but she is clean with a time of 34.75. So two clean runs for Team USA. Next up, we have Jeff Bothello with Matrix. Matrix is the youngest dog on this team at 4 years. And it goes in the tunnel. So an unfortunate disqualification.
But look at that power.
Very powerful dog. And Jeff tells us that his dog loves children. This is the first time we've seen someone
The breakaway tire.
Break the tire. So if the dog wasn't already eliminated, that would have been 5 faults.
But I would guess that he's handling differently now when he knows
yes,
already disqualified.
He's giving
his dog a blast.
Yes, they're just having fun. Jeff and Matrix. We have one more dog to go for Team USA, and this is an experienced handler. Daisy Peel with Frodo. She's been in fourth place individual before with her dog Solar. We're watching the tire here. Oh, he just takes off too early, lands in the tire. But what a great invention of the breakaway tire so that it's safe for the dog. This is Daisy and Frodo, and they need a clean run to keep the Team USA in the top. Nice. Oh, she goes on the outside of 9, and that's nice.
That's a very nice line. Beautiful.
Nice turn to 12.
Looking not much
good.
Space here.
No. He's very tight to the jumps,
but he's
keeping the bar top.
And she chooses to
rear cross.
Yeah. She chooses
but
to rear cross.
It's a clean run
very
for
nice
Daisy
run.
And Frodo. At 35.19, so three clean runs for Team USA. It won't put them at the top of the list, but it does give them a great position into the final. We have Team Greece, and they're fairly new. Oh, he falls down, but he recovers.
That was very quick up.
Yes, Christos Palasopoulos with Mio.
Oh, that's a pity.
Unfortunate elimination when the dog takes number 7 from the wrong side.
impressive, though, how fast he could get up from that fall.
He recovered quickly.
And really continue the race.
Yes. But sometimes it's a thing like that that puts you off balance, and then when you get a few obstacles down the line, you make another mistake just because you're stirred by that. But Team Greece are new in the World Championship scene. I haven't seen them for many years, and it's great to see them there. This next dog with Elpida Ismail is called Diesel, and he's only 2.5 years old as well, so a very young dog. It's their first time, obviously, at the World Championships. And she calls him a mommy's boy. Mm. Oh, he wants to come with mommy. He didn't stay in the weaves. There he goes. So that's a 5 fault. Nice end to the backside, but he dropped that bar as he came a little bit too close to the wing. Just a typical thing for a young dog to do. Nice power. Very fast on the straight lines.
A little bit too wide there. Very smooth handling.
Very smooth.
Now you run.
Very nice. And she rear crosses. Okay, so 10 faults, time of 40:26.
And you can see Judge Andreas, he's all over the course, all the time, always very attentive to the team. He sees everything.
He sees everything, he's always moving a lot. I like that in a judge, that they're active and really trying to do their best to see all the tunnel entries.
Everything. And his contacts feel, nothing escapes him.
That's true. So, third dog, we have a Malinois again. Drops the second pole, which is unfortunate. This dog's name is Pisa, with Themistocles Orkopoulos. Dog is 4.5 years old. Nice tight turns for a big dog like that, and he easily makes the blind. So 5 faults for Themistocles and Pizza.
Looking at the statistics here on the breeds, we talked about 179 border collies, right?
Yes.
Well, when it comes to the Belgian Shepherds, we have 10.
Yes. We have our last dog from Greece. Raitula Chazapi with Muffin. Clean so far. Oh, unfortunately a dropped bar. And the helpers immediately put that bar up because they're taking it again at number 17. A wide turn there, and the dog took the back side of 19. An elimination. Unfortunate for the young team Greece. Next up, we have Croatia. We have Jelko Gora with Gunga, another Malinois. Jelko is experienced. He's been in agility for 27 years. Gunga is 7.5 years old, and it's looking good.
He comes a lot to Sweden every year, I think, to for handling courses.
Yes, he teaches
together with Jenny
teaches
Dam.
With Jenny Dam. Mm-hmm. That's correct.
Very popular seminars.
And Shelko is also a judge. And we'll see him again as number 4 in this team.
Yeah.
So up now, we have Anja Placevic with Bua. And Anja is only 14 years old.
She must be one of the youngest handlers here
today.
Yes,
she's the youngest in the large team competition that I've seen. This is a Croatian sheepdog.
Mm-hmm.
So a native breed to Croatia. Very athletic little dog. This is her second time at the World Championships at 14. Isn't that amazing?
That is amazing.
The dog is 4 years old
and has a lot to tell her her owner when she's walking around on the course.
The Croatians are
very communicative.
They're loud. But that's a great clean run for Andra and Buha. Very nice. So two clean runs for Team Croatia. Next up, we have Nina Gregel with Vis. And Vis is a really, really fast dog. She's placed first in team agility run individual. She has set the best time in the World Championships many times. And this is her comeback to agility after a toe injury. The dog had a broken toe, but is now back. And it looks amazing. Such a fast dog. One of the fastest dogs in the world.
And look at that.
So tight, so fast. And she's keeping the bars up so far. Going for the slice on 18. She will make the blind. This will be
and a clean run.
Clean run.
Very nice.
33.52. That's a very nice time.
Not and a sign of that broken toe. That's really good.
No, dog has recovered. So up now again, Shelkogora, this time with Tama, a border collie. So he has the chance to solidify the Croatian result. All Croatian dogs so far have been clean. Can he put Croatia into the lead? Very nice and steady. Oh no, he drops a bar.
Aww.
Unfortunate.
Very nice run.
It's the first time we've seen someone drop that bar, I think. Just takes off too early and lands on top of the bar. Five falls in a time of 35.14. And they go into fourth place.
So we're Italy in the lead still.
Sweden second, Austria third, and Croatia fourth.
There we go.
Yes.
And just
team
seconds in between them in time.
Yes, very tight in the top. We have Team Hungary. And this is a Moody, a large Moody. It's Agnes Kovacs with Lolka.
Oh.
Unfortunately, a dropped bar at number 7. So there are a lot of Moodies in the medium class, and I've even seen some in small, probably not here, but in Sweden. But this is a large Moody. She makes the blind easily. So 35.56, unfortunately one drop bar and five faults. Next up, we have Lilla Sokol with Cassie. Another border collie. Nicely into the weaves.
Very smooth handler.
She stays with the dog, front crosses, and has to push out, but she does that very nicely. This is a tight dog. Pushing out of the tunnel, clean so far. Very nice. So two jumps to go, and she makes the blind.
And
a clean run, 35.75. Third dog for Team Hungary is Julia Fosse with Tig. Beautiful brown, smooth-coated border collie. Correct entry, but then went out of the weaves,
and
which gives everything.
The handler,
wrong.
I think she dropped. She knocked down the bar, the first bar, and then the dog they hold wing.
Yes. So when the handler drops the bar before the dog takes the jump, that's an elimination. So unfortunately, they are eliminated. Beautiful dog. Very nice. Like a panther.
Mm.
And there they go. So we have two more dogs to go. No, we have one more dog.
This
is a very exciting dog. They were second in the individual world championships last year. Her name is Anita Silaji, and the dog's name is Dita, and they are fast.
They start their starting routine with some obedience.
Yes.
Before she starts.
The dog is excited to get going.
Yeah, I understand.
She can do. She goes for the slice into the tunnel. Nice tight turn on four, perfectly into the weaves. Very nice independence. Perfect so far. Nicely around 12. Very responsive dog, very tight lines. Oh, she's too tight. She refuses. So an unfortunate refusal and a time of 36.85.
So next, Brazil is coming up. Number 29, team 29, Brazil. And we are starting with Marcela Cecchia. With Angel or Angel.
Nice weaves. Oh, she pushes the dog out.
She didn't get anything for that, I think.
No, but we have an elimination as the dog takes an extra jump.
Brazil is also a country with a long. Quite a long agility tradition, though, or you see them and they have really good results when they are out there. They come to participate in many championships here in Europe. And the second dog, exactly, that's going to run is Eva. And the handler that seems quite young is Alessandro Borges. Alexandre Borges de Brazil.
He stays with the dog in the weaves.
They were lucky there.
He was lucky.
He lost the sight of the dog.
But he made it, and he got a good line to seven as the dog came out wide from the weaves. Nice and smooth now. Oh, he drops a bar on the wrap on 18. And then he makes the blind. We have five faults and a time of 38.84.
Third handling coming in here. It's a border collie. Her name is Flora. And the handler is Riccardo Tubaldini.
Very white border collie.
It's a wide turn there.
Nice turn to the weaves. He stays with the dog as well, and then he has to run, but he's fast. He can outrun his dog. I wish I could. He's giving his all to show the dog perfect lines. The dog is barking around the course. Oh, he makes
a
line.
And he makes a blind cross, yes. And
we have a clean run.
A clean run. There you go. 36.25 in time. And we have the last team here. When it comes to Team Brazil. And that is another border collie called Raiva. And the handler is Moab Mordornio. And we have had, what did we have before here? He needs to make a clean run here.
Yes. And he drops
and
a bar.
Drops a bar, that's a pity.
Very tight on nine, but he keeps the bar up. pushes to 12. The bar stays up. He stays on that side of 16, which is very nice. He wraps 18. Oh, he drops the 19. Another five faults. 36-80.
Still Italy in the lead. Sweden second. Austria third. And Croatia fourth team in ranking.
So up next we have Team Latvia. And this is a young dog, only 3 years old. Dog's name is Chili, with Natalia Loginova. And Natalia has been to 4 world championships. But this is a young dog, so can't have been more than twice. Nice so far. Screaming in the weaves. Clearing the jumps. Nice. You can tell it's a young dog.
Yeah, exactly.
But it's fast and it's clean. Into the last tunnel. Easily makes the blind.
And there
we have a clean run at 33.79, which is a good time. We have Gepa with Karina Grigore from Latvia. Second dog, a red merle. Very nice so far. Responsive dog, fast handler. And a very nice turn from 11 to 12, one of the best I've seen today.
Did you see how fast she came out of the tunnel?
Yes, but very tight. So this is good. And she easily makes the blind to 21. We have a clean run at 34.58. And this dog coming up is even younger. It's only 2 years old. It's called Shori with Jekaterina Akimova. And all the dogs in this team are related. This is the daughter. One of the other dogs is the mother and then two aunts. So
it's a family thing.
Family team, yes.
Family thing here.
Wow, she pushes out of the weaves. This dog is very responsive for 2 years old and very fast. This dog's really good.
This is looking good.
Very good. Team Latvia, very nice.
Beautiful turn.
And she rear crosses. But it was a nice rear cross. Time of 34.43. And we have one dog left for Team Latvia. And this is a very experienced and fast dog called Salsa. She was placed first in the individual jumping last year at the World Championships. So this is a fast, fast dog. And she goes into weaves and she pushes out of the weaves very nicely. Pushes to the backside of 7. Perfect jump on 9. Let's see the turn out of the tunnel. Oh, no! She doesn't turn out of the tunnel, and she takes number 12 from the wrong side. Still a very nice total for Team Latvia.
It's a very nice fluid course that Andreas has made here.
Yes.
With its perks,
Latvia goes into third place. And we have Team Norway coming up. Norway is always making a lot of noise. This is Merete Mølholm with Easy.
There are quite a few Norwegians here.
Yes. The Norwegians they have a great sense of their team, and they travel all over Europe to support their team. Always one of the loudest fans. Looking good so far for Merete and Easy. This is a young dog, only 2 years old. Merete's been to the World Championships before with a Sheltie. Can she make the blind? She does make the blind, and she is clean.
And has
the Norwegians go crazy. We have a clean run for Norway. Next dog up for Norway is Aina Bjellundqvist with Enzo. Enzo is 5 years old, and Aina's been doing this for a long time. She's in control. She's been 8 times to the World Championships with 3 different dogs. Nicely into the weaves and independent weaves. She's way ahead of her dog. Very nice. Aina is 57 years old. She can still handle a very fast dog with good independent skills.
A little bit of wide turns.
Yes, but looking good for Team Norway. She rear crosses 21,
and
they are clean.
Run. And Norway is celebrating.
2 clean runs for Team Norway. Oh, I'm sorry. I told you that Aina was 57, but she didn't want to tell us her age. But this is Bård. He is 57 years old, and his dog is named Zappa. Zappa is 7 years old, and it's his first World Championship, and the pressure is on for Bård and Zappa. No! He takes the wrong side of 8. Unfortunate elimination, but we have 1 dog left to go in Team Norway. They can still go into one of the top positions. Another backside for Zappa. Okay, 4th dog for Team Norway is an experienced dog with an experienced handler. This is Gosh with Lise Irene Hansen for Norway. Leaving her dog at the start line. Oh, Gosh gets up, but she is in control. Nice tight turn to the weaves. Perfect weave entry, good independence. It's all about them now. Can they keep Norway clean? Or would wide turn out of the tunnel, but she manages. We have number 16, perfect. Number 17. Just a few jumps left.
It's a home stretch here.
Yes, she goes for the rear cross. And she has a refusal and an elimination.
What a pity.
So close. That was very unfortunate.
Beautiful
for Team
run,
Norway.
Though. She must be a little bit disappointed there. She's an experienced handler. Has done
yes.
this many times before.
I think that rear cross, she should have gone for the blind.
There are quite a few handlers that get hesitating in just, you know, in a split second.
Yes. You don't want to crash with your dog.
You don't want to crash it with
okay.
your dog. You don't
want on to course now, we have Team Germany. And they are one of the best teams in the world. And this is Anne Lenz with G. She was world champion 2 years ago in Spain. She was 2nd in team last year. This dog is 7 years old. Very fast, very experienced. Mm. And Anne is running 2 dogs in this team event. They are clean with a time of 34.53. Great start for Team Germany. Next up, we have a Blue Merle Border Collie named Peach with Jeremiah Simpson. Germany has so many great teams that just getting on the German team is a feat, and he gets a refusal.
Can he manage to get in face again here? He does.
And
he's back.
No. Bar, another refusal, and a 3rd refusal, which leads to an elimination. So this puts the pressure on.
The last dog?
No, we have two more dogs.
Have yes.
Max Behrendt, who won the European Open, and we have Anne Lenz, who is so experienced. I think they can make it anyway. Let's cross our fingers. So, up now, we have Bex with Max Sprints. They won the European Open. They were clean in all the runs at the European Open. They won the German team tryouts. This guy is only 18 years old. The dog is just turned 3. They are new agility superstars.
You could say so, for sure.
We are so excited to see what they can do at the World Championship. I think Max has nerves of steel. It looks so easy when he runs Becks. Into the weaves. Push back to 7.
Outside.
The arena goes quiet. No problem so far.
Oh, beautiful.
Oh,
that is
that
beautiful.
Is beautifully
Look at that.
Handled, and he makes the rear
and
blind cross.
Yeah, he makes a blind cross, and he has to push out the dog there.
33-93, and a clean run. This puts all the pressure on Anna Lentz and Itsy Bitsy. This is her younger dog. It's only 3 years old, but already very accomplished. So, let's see what Anna can do. Very nice tight wrap on 2. Perfect turn into the weaves. Pushing out of the weaves. Come on. Get that backside. Oh no, she drops a bar.
Yeah.
Team Germany.
A risky business going on that side on the weaves and
yes,
then have to run all the way.
She didn't really get out of the way from the weaves. Unfortunate. We have 5 faults for Team Germany. Very nice fast run at 33.86. Unfortunately, a bar.
That didn't put them that very high in the ranking, but there's still one. We have the agility team left.
Yes, everything can happen.
Everything can happen.
So we have Team Slovenia. We're down to the last 3 teams. This is Slovenia. This is Maša Ceglar with Maggie. Very nice so far. Fast dog. Very nice tight turn there. She can make the blind. Nicely jumping dog. 34.75 for Maša and Maggie. Up next, we have an 8.5-year-old dog named Lynn with handler Polona Bonac. Just falling a bit before the weaves, but she recovered. Going very nicely now into the tunnel. Can she get that turn? Yes. She touches the bar, but it stays up. Very nicely handled to 16. Takes the slice on 18. She's far ahead, she'll make the blind. We have a clean run for Polona and Lynn, 34-47. So 2 clean runs for Team Slovenia. On course now, we have Daria Skripcia with Ched. Oh, Ched goes out of the weaves and then gets a refusal when he tries to enter them again. So we have 10 faults. This is their first World Championship. The dog is 4.5 years old, so still a young dog. Nice slice on 18. And she rear crosses, but she does it very nicely. So 39.80 with some problems in the weaves. Now, last dog for Team Slovenia is agility superstar Sylvia Turkman with 2. Sylvia has won the world championships 3 times with 2 different dogs in the medium category. She's won the European Open 5 times with both medium and large dogs.
Oh, that's awesome.
This
good.
Is exciting.
That's nice. Look at that independence.
Yes. I know that this dog has some trouble jumping the tight slices, so I think Sylvia will do everything to keep them up, and she does. This is a difficult jump for her, but she manages. Very nice. Such a fast dog. 2 jumps to go.
She
does not make the blind.
She didn't make the blind cross.
And there's an elimination. And I think Sylvia is a very fast runner, but she has to always be with the dog to make sure the bar stays up. And this leaves her behind for an elimination. So unfortunate. That was a very nice run for Sylvia, too. We are down to the 2 last teams. This is Team Ukraine.
So we have Ukraine and we have France.
Yes.
Still to go.
First dog, Team Ukraine. We have Olena Bokova with Fora. And she misses the weave entry. 5 faults picked up there. This dog is just 3 years old, but it's already her second world championship. And she was placed individual last year at number 17. Nice turn on 18. Does she make the blind? She does. Very nice.
Very nice course.
37-70 with fault in the weaves. Second dog for Team Ukraine. The dog is named Roy and it's a border collie with handler Natalia Denishenko. 3 years old, this dog. First world championship. Beautiful black and white border collie. Nice handling there. In the lead. Oh no, a refusal picked up at 17. And she gets to 18 with no faults. Will she make the blind? Yes, just barely. So we have a one refusal, 1 fault, time of 40-76. So in first place, we still have Team Italy, second place Sweden, third place Latvia. Our third dog for Team Ukraine. No, this is our last dog. No? Third dog, Daria Skripcia with Ched.
Ukraine is out of the picture right now for the ranking list here.
Yes,
the
and we have
ranking.
A bar for this dog as well.
But to our last team, which is France, if they're going to make it to the top three, they will have to have 3 clean runs and they need to beat 102.09, which is Italy's total time, or Sweden's 102.76, or Latvia's with the 3 clean runs they need to have and 102.80.
So they're just
those are the times that we are dealing with.
0.04 seconds behind Sweden, Latvia. It's very, very close going into the final run tomorrow. So we have Rico on the course with Natalia Vostrovskaya-Nova. Nice so far. Nice push back to 12. Oh, she drops 13. I think it's the first dog that I've seen to drop that. And she pulls the dog to the wrong side of 16 and is eliminated. It's so easy to lose your concentration after your dog drops a bar. Now, Team France.
Team France has a huge supporter group here. I think they have like one-fourth of a... No, not that much, but one-sixth of an arena here.
Dog's name is Gumball. It's a red merle border collie. Handler, Adrien Despierre. Experienced team, this. It's a clean run.
It's a clean run, and he is happy.
34-71.
I'm looking here at the course with all the obstacles that we have here, and I see at least 3 points of improvement that has been very important when it comes to agility development. And we're talking about the long jump, which are soft pieces. We are talking about the tire that is a soft tire and also with as less metal as possible. And the tunnels. The tunnels are inside is made of anti-slippery material on all the way around in the inside of the tunnel. Very important for the safety of our dogs.
On course now, we have Anthony Gimont with Inox. He is clean so far, and it looks like a really nice run. Very fast, efficient dog. Beautiful jumper. He makes the blind. Two yes. dogs left. Oh, and he's clean! 34-18. Two clean runs for Team France. Our third dog is called Hindi, another border collie with Michelle Weber. Nicely into the weaves. Good push back to seven.
Nice handling.
Yes, into the tunnel. Nice turn to 12. Very good jump for this dog. Keeping the bars up. Nice tight turns. Just two jumps left to go. We have another clean run for Team France.
This is getting hot in here.
Yes, we have three clean runs for Team France. And for the last competitor of this class, Christophe Dalma with Haston, he just needs to push for speed to put France in the lead. Fast dog. Fast dog. Wide turns.
Look at that. Smoking when he's running on that
yes
surface.
Very nice so far.
And they manage the outside.
Yes.
He is pushing for speed, he is.
Yes, and that's what he should be doing when they have three clean runs. It's all about the speed of the fourth dog.
And he is.
He is fast. The dog is fast. 34-43. I don't think this will put them in the lead, but let's see where it puts them. We have. Still don't know where France is placed. Waiting for the final results in this class. We know that it's a good day so far for Team Sweden. We have Italy in the lead. We have Sweden within just much less than a second. We have Latvia in the same second.
And then the French guys, they came in at fourth. Really
France.
Nice run.
Under a second behind Italy, so anything can happen tomorrow. We have Austria in fifth, we have Croatia in sixth, Japan seventh, Belgium eighth, Finland ninth, and Slovakia 10. So we have 18 clean runs or clean teams. All of them are able to do something tomorrow.
Very exciting for tomorrow's run.
Yes. Thank you very much, Katrina.
Thank you,
Fanny. Thank you to everybody who's been watching us.
Stay tuned.
Stay tuned for medium team jumping.
And it's so, so tight. With 102.09, the second has 102.76, and the third has 102.80. It's so close. But it's my pleasure to say that the winner of this class is Italy!
We'll see if Latvia would like to show up. We'll wait a few more seconds to see if they show up, Latvia. Okay, so in first place, Italy, please step up on the podium. Yeah. And in second place, Sweden. And in third place, we have Latvia, but they are not here. Here they are! Latvia! Give them a big round of applause, come on! Let's give them a huge round of applause again. Okay, and I would like Italy to come down here and speak to me, if that's fine. Guys, how does it feel to start off like this?
It really feels great. Yeah, amazing.
And tomorrow, you're going out first, or last, sorry, not first. Do you have a special tactic, or what do you think about that?
I think we'll start like we haven't run yesterday at all. So we'll start from the beginning again and don't think about anything else.
Right. Good luck, everybody. Italy, everybody!